for that behaviour. But, as you can possibly guess from that particular tune, it is an Olympic bumper quiz. Here for you, a wee special Olympic bumper quiz. Sorry. A few wee technical issues there, I just want to take care of. But, we have Olympic bumper quiz coming up for you. What was I going to say there? I've just completely lost the whole train of thought there. But yes, it is. One of these special quizzes for you. Just to take part in if you're interested. Lots of five rounds in total. So it's kind of very similar, I have to say, to the Sunday... I'm just going to type that in there. Olympic pub quiz. Right. It's just one of those similar to a Sunday bumper quiz, but we have five rounds, 10 questions in each, a couple of music rounds in there for you as well, for you to mull over, and some decent wee questions. If you like your Olympics, this is right up your street, because of course the Olympics was meant to have been starting already. When it's been filmed, I think they were meant to start this weekend over in Tokyo, and they're being delayed to next year, as is the plan. So it's just play along at home. You don't send me your answers or anything like with the old quizzes. The answers will be given at the end of this stream. Okay, so without further ado, charge your glasses. If you're having a wee drink while doing this, then hello to you. There we go. The round one is Name the National Anthem. Yes, Name the National Anthem. It's something that we see all the time at the Olympic Games, a wee national anthem when the medals are being handed out. So some of these are very familiar. Be a couple of obscure ones in there for you. But anyway, without further ado, let's get started. So again, here we go. Name this national anthem, folks. Help Gary if you were prepared and ready. Here we go. Here's your first one. There's a wee bit there, it plays on a wee bit, just a little bit. So. That wee bit might be a bit more familiar to these folks there for question number one there. Okay, right, without further ado, let's get on to number two. Here we go. Say pretty easy as well, would you know? Aye. Right, here's question number three, folks. Question number three for yous in this one. Who's this one? Remember, you can rewind these back and listen to them again. That was number three. We now move on to, quite naturally, number four. Here we go. Oh, well, some of you might not know it clued up in your national anthems, but anyway, that was number four. Let's move on to number five. Here we go. Carried away there. So that was number five. Number six for you folks. Here we go. Interesting one there for number six. Number seven. Remember, if you know a bit of your football as well, watch like World Cups and stuff like that, you might help you out with this as well. Right, here we go. Here's number a little bit, it's just a pretty bland for the kind of country it is. I know it's quite a bland one. That's all right. Three more to go. Here's number eight for you. That's what I know. You should know that. And your final one, number 10 here, folks. What's this one? Number 10. Strange one, that one, in a way, because it kind of leads you to think that it's a John Wayne movie that's about to start there, don't it? Right, that was your 10 national anthems there, folks. You can rewind them all back, pause it, listen, do what you want, if you want to hear them again. But in the meantime, let's have a wee break from that, and let's get a bit of proper music on here, not to diss the national anthems, but anyway. Right, we're going to play some music that featured in, I don't know if any of you've seen it recently again, they repeated the opening ceremony of the London 2012 Olympics. Magnificent show, and music featured heavily throughout it. So in the wee breaks, I'll play you some songs that featured during that break. So let's start off with a bit of Zeppelin. Trampled Underfoot, by the way. Track that's Trampled Underfoot by Led Zeppelin, of course. Led Zeppelin. Right, let's move on to your next round, which is a picture round in Olympians. As it says, that's all it is, really. Going to see 10 pictures of Olympians, okay? Just name who they are. For the second name here for a point, folks. So there is number one. Who is that? Then sometimes think, oh, geez, did I make sure that when I pick these pictures that they sometimes have the their name across the front of it, didn't they? That one's no. Unless you're one of the Olympics, I think this one's quite not that difficult, but unless you're one of the stats that know, yeah, that athlete was awarded number 1729, and I know that straight away off the top of my head, that is such and such. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's number one there. Who's that? That's number two. Yeah. It's actually a picture only taken 2 years ago there is, or that's a picture actually, no, 2 years ago, 2 months ago, because of lockdown. Pearson Sayers went a riot. Going on a wee tash there as well. No, it's not 2 months ago. quite please you, I'm sure there. I don't know if that picture was for a sports magazine or for some other magazine. What's that? Yeah. You know? Okay, you can't pause these, of course. Let's move on to number three. Oh, she looks happy with herself there. That's her just jumped into the pool to start the backstroke now. She's not done anything. That's not finished the race. She's just happy that she made it into the pool in the first place. True. First in the pool. Yeah, one. Oh, you've got to do the race then. All right. But I was just making that up, of course. Who is she? Okay. So that was number three. Here is number four. Who is she? And I'll give you, I interviewed this lassie after the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow in 2014, after she won gold there as well. Very pleasant woman, very pleasant. Well, she had just won a gold medal, so she was pretty happy. And in fact, I seen her in the pub after it. No word of a lie, she was in the clockwork. After it, we had all went for a drink because it was, I think it was the Saturday night of the competition. Was that the last night? No. Anyway, we'd all went for a drink. And she came in with some of her teammates. And sat and she was having a wee drink. And they were all very, very boisterous. And one of them went away to the chippy and came in with two big bags of chips. Filled back up in the carbs. That's what it is, sorry. But who is she? Who is she? Who is she? It's number four. There's number five. Very small person, that. That's not somebody standing up high. She's a very small person. No. Hi, Mum. Okay, so that's number five. Here is number six. Lovely bouquet of flowers there, son. Don't know why they give that to the guys. I'm not being... Right, then, I may have been a bit sexist here. I've been a bit thingy about that. And apologies. Bottle of beer wouldn't get hang in that situation, I'm sure. A lot of these Olympians, when they drink alcohol. Maybe eat a lot of chips. Mind you, in saying that, the last year I was talking about that was in the clockwork, I think she had a wee vino. Aye. Bag of chips. Salted and used the wine as beer as vinegar. Did. Well, that was number six. There's number seven. One of the greats. One of the greats. Saying the distance, I could. You're basically saying, when I was in my prime, mate, I would have beaten you by that distance, meaning if Mo Farah there. The size of my medals cabinet. Chock full of medals, this guy. And records. Aye, records. Big Duran Duran fan he was. Got other albums. Aye. You've got to be a new romantic. Catch a goo-goo as well, he liked. Right, number eight. Lucky bastard. Lucky person, sorry. Lucky bastard. That's a terrible guy. Lucky lassie. She's got two medals there. That's spoiled. Superb athlete, though. Superb athlete. Just a shame that. I was just trying to think of what sport I would be good at in the Olympics. Talking shite. I would do well on that one. Talking shite. Gold medal, Gary McDaniel. Talking shite. There's number nine. Just spotted somebody in the crowd there, they knows. Is that him after Daly? Well, it must be sitting in the commentary box, that's what it is. All right. It's funny now how deep the Olympic swimming pools are. Very deep. Struggle. Not a strong swimmer, me. But don't be lying in the water. Don't be lying in there. And I'm talking about that. I can forget washed, not that, of course, but that sort of thing. Hassle of going to the swimming, innit? You got the weans of the swimming in you. You get them all in and the flares soaking wet. And you get back into the changing rooms and you're getting changed and dry and you're cloaking in. When you're trying to get back ready, you're still a bit damp and fucking clothes are sticking and you're trying to get away and the wean's fucking opening the door while you're can try to get yourself ready. Don't open the door! People walking by. Oh, getting all that. Stress, 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 stress. And the thing is about it, see, when you get into the pool, it's boring, isn't it? Fucking boring. There's number 10. That's her doing that thing where, see, when you're walking along the street, and it's the paved slabs, and you don't want to stone in the, one of the cracks. She's taking that a bit for her, but that's what she's doing now. Any word of a lie? Okay, so at number 10, very famous, very famous. So you can't rewind them back, pause them, do what you want. For the moment, let's get back to the Muzak. And she sung live at the 2012 opening ceremony, this lassie. And she sang, was it Abide by Me, Abide With Me? Very poignant. But here, this song also featured Heaven. Emily Sandy, Scotland's very own.
put you away. Our tribe would always break, cause the day always lasts too long.
Emily Sandy there in Heaven. Heaven. Yeah, I like that song actually. I'm not a massive Emily Sandy fan, but I do like that song. I do. Okay, right, round number three is simply named the host city of the Summer Olympics. This is, of course. Going to give you the year. You simply tell me which was the host city that year. So if you know your stuff there, you might do very well here. Here we go. So number one is, which city hosted in 1936? Who was a host city in 1936? Think about that one, aye. I'm not going to get any clues in this regards. No. Looking for the city, remember, not the country. We all know that the Summer Olympics are synonymous with host cities. So that's 1936. Which city hosted it in 1992, which was a host city in 1992? Missing the Olympics, I must admit, I'm not going to miss it. And they're actually saying, I was reading a report the day, that a lot of the Japanese are only too keen, actually, even for it next year, if COVID's still hanging about, because they've closed off all their borders now, and they're like, no, we don't want anybody coming in, because it's not just the Tokyo itself, you're talking about all the towns and villages and cities out with that, which are going to be like, where a lot of some of the training camps are based for some of the countries, so. And then you've got all the people that are going to be coming out, all the people that want to go to the events for around the world. Aye, you wonder if it will happen, eh? Right, number three. Which city hosted it in the year 2000? In 2000, which city hosted it? The Japanese might just write it off and just say, no, forget the Olympics, this run, just leave it to the... Who's hosting it after them? Is it Los Angeles? Or is it? I know Paris and Los Angeles are the next two host cities, aren't they? But, aye. Anyway, who's hosted it in the year 2000? Okay, and question number four. Which was a host city in 1976? Host city in 1976. We've been in Tokyo, though the time difference would have been quite. Remember when the World Cup was in Japan and South Korea in 2002, and games were kicking off in the morning. It was no bad. I remember there was one. Oh, it was like a Sunday morning. There was like four games, like for like 7 in the morning right through to like tea time, and I was like, I remember being rough as anything, and I just crawled out of my bed, lay there, one game after another. I was like, this is bliss, man. And then phoned a chicken curry and fried rice. Brilliant. The wee guy brought it up the stairs to us. The only days up in Dumbarton Road. Okay, right, question number five. Who was the host city in 1948? Who was the host city in 1948? So the time difference was, because the first Olympics I really remember were in 1988, And I've no good doing that, doing it as a question. You know, I'm needing to always remember what's ahead here, Gary, because I might give you an answer or something. But anyway, aye. And I remember watching some of that in the mornings as well, in 1988, because it was in Seoul, wasn't it? Right, question number six, which was a host city in 1980? Which was a host city in 1980? Got a wee music round to end it off. Music and Olympics, can't it? Well, come to that. I've changed it last minute. I was actually, it was odd, the songs that I'm playing in between the break, I was going to feature that as, you know, this is for the 2012 opening ceremony, but I sacked that idea. Number seven, which was a host city in 1896. Way back then, which was a host city in 1896. No, it's not a typo.
Gary, was it
not
1996 you might put in there?
No. It's 1896. Aye. Imagine if I was involved with the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, and that was great. You know what I mean? It was brilliant to be part of it all, and the weather was actually not bad as well, which was a shock. You just imagine Glasgow holding the Olympics. I was a member of the Billy Connolly story about if they were, and it was the walking race. Now, like, guys practising, like, walking about Lamb Hill or Rock Hill doing that walk. They wouldn't get away with that, you know. Fucking hell, mate. Right, question number eight. Which city hosted it in 1960? 1960 Olympics. Which was a host city? But you can ask either Jew when they did the Commonwealth Games. You know what I mean? You had Hampden was great, but obviously they had to adapt it off, put a running track around it, and they actually they lifted the pitch, so they took out the first four or five rows of the stand run there. Because I remember after the games, it took about 6 months to get Hampden back to, you know, back to its normality. Because we went, I remember to Hampden around about September after it. And it was mental when it lifted up all the track and all that, and you just seen, like, where did I think the track ended up out somewhere else in Scotland, I'm sure the track's in there. I ran around that track, broke the 1500 metre record. My own personal best. Had a pair of jeans on and a t-shirt. Fucking mental. Question nine. Which city hosted 1968? Which was host city in 1968? Aye. But the days they had like they called a press day. So everybody that was involved in like the news service team and all the journals and all that. It was just like, it was like one of the days there was no afternoon session. So we got a phone call, right, aye, come on, dude. You have to run around the track, everybody's to get, I'm not, but some folk came for like getting out, you know what I mean? Fucking, who do you think he is? Fucking Sebco. And I'm like, I'm not taking this, man, because if I fucking run around there, I say it's only 400 metres and I'll collapse, and I'll be sweating, and I'm here all day and night. I'm fucking minging. Oh, come on, you've got to do it. Look, your name's on the board. Oh, so it is. All right, then. Oh, thankfully, there was about four or five other folk that were worse than me, so I felt quite good. I lapped one of them. Question number 10, 1956. Who was host city in 1956? Ah, that wee guy. You might have seen his face. I mean, he was about 89. And he had a walking stick. Keep the guy due.
But yeah,
it's like I'm targeting him. I'm over. I'm lapping him. Need to lap him. thing is, see, when you see them when they're running, when athletes are, they're meant to move out the inside and allow the faster runners on the inside. He didn't. Stubborn wee git. Really did my time. Took about 2 seconds off my time. I could have had 2 seconds off my time if he had moved out of the way, but there you go. Okay, right, so that's that round done, round number three. Remember, you can rewind them back if you have any. We'll have a wee music break, as I say. And here's the wee song for you. Oh, a bit of the Sex Pistols, pretty vacant. One of the best intros ever. There's a wee bit of an urban myth about when that song was played at the opening ceremony of the Olympics or in the stand. The way they'd set it up was that these, every seat had that, like these lights, and for what was happening it would light up the whole stadium. It was brilliant. And then when that song came on, the lyrics appeared in the stands, and there's the, because he goes, Johnny Rotten goes, "Pretty vacant, can't." It's the sort of like the African thing, South African accent, isn't it? You can't say that. It's Alan Partridge, if you watch that, there's a famous scene in that. Anyway, the urban myth is that when the lyrics appeared, it wasn't vacant, V-A-C-A-N-T, it was V-A-C-U-N-T, and it came up like the C-U-N-T in big, big work letters. It's not true. It's an E. That is an E. No A-U. Anyway, just a wee. The spelling wee urban myths there, like Bob Holness playing saxophone in Baker Street and all that sort of nonsense. Okay. Oh, round number four is about the Olympics. Oh, really? Yeah. Here we go. Here is your first question. Question number one. Usain Bolt broke the world record for both the 100 metres and 200 metres at which Olympic Games? So you can either give me the year or the city. Usain Bolt broke the world record for both the 100 metres and 200 metres at which Olympic Games? Great guys. Gave him a high five at Glasgow. Right. Brilliant. I know I keep going on about it. But it was brilliant. You know what I mean? He is, without doubt, one of the great sportsmen in history, in my point of view. And he didn't really seem to bother. It's like not an effort for him. I don't know. It's just like, hi. I just turn up, go like that, give it all that, and all that. And all the other guys beside him are like, you know, just pure good, rage, then they get themselves born. He's like, okay, bye. 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 Anyway, that was question one. Question number two, who did Andy Murray defeat in the gold medal match at the 2016 Rio Olympics? Who did Andy Murray defeat in the gold medal match at the 2016 Rio Olympics? That's tennis, by the way, tennis. In which case, it was another Andy Murray playing some other sport. It was a hellier final as well. Brilliant final. Who did they beat, though? It's a thing, isn't it? Right, question number three. At which games was a bomb planted at an Olympic park where fans gathered? The bomb detonated whilst an evacuation was taking place, killing one person. At which games was a bomb planted at an Olympic park where fans gathered? The bomb detonated whilst an evacuation was taking place, killing one person. And see, the thing is about that, see the guy that received the coded message or the warning, and he started to evacuate the park. And he was told he was given, well, it was going to be like in 15 minutes, it was going to go off. And he ran about trying to get everybody out. But it went off like within 5 minutes. He was actually the main, he was, I think he was charged with it as being the culprit. Poor guy. Eventually caught the real person. If the person had a track history of doing it. Shock. Who would have thought?
I know, go to the guy that's had a track history doing it first, you know, rather than some poor wee security guy.
Right, question number four. Although he represented Canada, in which country was disgraced sprinter Ben Johnson born? Remember that, Ben Johnson? He was another one that remember World Cup 94 and Diego Maradona, remember he scored that goal and he ran out of the camera and he went, you know, done that, and everybody went, yuck, you must have. Which is that's a lot of nonsense. Just because he did that, you think, right, he's fucking full of the drugs. Well, he was, but people, you just had to look at him and know he was on it. But with Ben Johnson, when you looked at him, you did think, you know what I mean, he was like bulging all over. He was like a caricature sort of figure, wasn't he? He was just like, so with no shock, when I remember watching Olympic grandstand in Des Lynham, turned around and said, yeah, we've got some breaking news and Ben Johnson tested positive for drugs. Don't say. But which country was he born? Right, question number five. In 2016, golf returned to the Olympics. Which golfer won the gold medal in the men's individual event? In 2016, golf returned to the Olympics. Which golfer won the gold medal in the men's individual event? A wee bit of golf. Not bad, isn't it? In the Olympics. That is one of a big high-profile sport, isn't it? Quite rightly, should be there. Did the Caddies get a medal? No, I suppose they don't. Shame, though. Deserve one. Anyway, who won it in 2016? Which guy? which golfer won the men's individual event at the 2016 golf tournament at Rio? Question number six. Which of the following cities has never hosted a Summer Olympic Games? Which of the following cities has never hosted a Summer Olympic Games? Is it Antwerp, Helsinki, St. Louis, or Madrid? Which of the following cities has never hosted a Summer Olympic Games? Antwerp, Helsinki, St. Louis, or Madrid? Raining pretty heavily out there, folks. Absolutely hosing it. That's July for you. I think our summer's always like April, May, beginning of June, and then it just goes, just when, like when they say when the schools finish. Although the Wains have had a prolonged summer holiday this year, haven't they? Right, question number seven. Since the Second World War, the leading nation at the Olympics has either been the USSR, Soviet Union, or the USA. Apart from twice, though. Once when a unified team won most medals in 1992, but which other nation has topped the medals table at the Games? Since the Second World War, the leading nation at the Olympics has either been the Soviet Union or the Americans. Apart from twice, once when it was a unified team, which was mostly made up of ex-Soviet athletes who won the most medals in 92, but which other nation has topped the medals table at the Games? So, one other nation actually broke that stranglehold that the Soviets and the Americans had. At what Games was it? So again, you can either say the city or the year. Or both. It's up to you. Completely up to you. He's been to the pub. What'd you make it? I know, I just don't. I think it's going to change dramatically. I think a lot of folk are just like, the new is still a bit too, I don't know. I've been in the Mill House twice, and Stuart and here done it twice. Once for a drink, and me and my mate John just sat there after a lamp pint and went, could just be sitting out of yours out of the back garden. There's point sitting in here. There's Kerry out there. You know what I mean? There was nothing going on. There was no... I don't know. It just seemed a weird atmosphere. And then there was folk that just didn't give a shit about social distancing. They're like fucking stoning about and crowding around the bar. And you're like... And I went in for a meal though. Beautiful. And again, I must thank Fiverr Skull. Token went down a treat. I got myself a lovely ribeye steak. With creamy mashed potatoes, pepper and brandy sauce. Oh, beautiful. Started off with Cullen skink. And, it was lovely. The wee man and the missus enjoyed it as well. Beautiful. They didn't get in. They just sat and watched me eat. Question eight. Which one of the following sports has featured at a Summer Olympics? Which one of the following sports has featured at a Summer Olympics? Is it cricket, squash, bowls, or horse racing? Which one of the following sports has featured at a Summer Olympics, a modern Summer Olympics? Cricket, squash, bowls, or horse racing? So this is the modern Olympics, not the ancient Olympics. The modern Olympics started in 1896. I might give you a clue. Oh, no. And the pubs are a wee bit. Some pubs are open, some pubs are low, and they know. And they know, and they know. Well. Some pubs have opened and then shut again. So I believe. Don't know when the pub quizzes will come back though, folks. Not allowed to play loud music. No. Because people might need to talk over each other and that might lead to like spitting all that coming out of their mouth. So you're probably not allowed a quiz because people will be shouting out answers and talking amongst their team. Yeah, what do you think? No. So might need to wait till God knows when. So I might need to make a return with this pub quiz palaver later. If it gets to that stage, eh? We shall see. Right, question number 9. Who was the director? Oh, I've been groaning about it. Who was the director of the Olympic opening ceremony at the London 2012 Games? Who was the director for the Olympic opening ceremony at the London 2012 Games? And made a fantastic job of it, if I do say so myself. I'm meant to be going for a pint tomorrow, after dinner up in Glasgow. And I'm a bit, but it's a bit of a pain, because all the pubs, literally, you need to book. Literally, I'm sounding like my boy, keeps using that word, literally. Dad, I literally put the plate on the table. I know you've literally put the plate. I literally said to him, no. I'm watching too much of that YouTube. Anyway. You're going around all these pubs phoning or emailing. No, I've not got anything available, we're full. And then my bra was telling me, but what's happening, and I think it's happening with the restaurants as well, is people are booking them but not turning up. So the pubs are half full when they're expected to be full. So do you take the chance of just saying, well, that might happen, there'll be folk that don't turn up, so you just go to the pub anyway? I don't know, we'll just wait and see. Right, question number 10. Which is the only continent not to have staged a Summer Olympic Games? Which is the only continent to not have staged a Summer Olympics? I'm not including Antarctica in that, by the way, folks. You can get Antarctica. Never done it. Never even staged a Winter Olympics. I don't know, I'll see. I'm missing that wee bit of banter, wee Saturday afternoon session, watch the racing, you know what I mean? But we'll see. Anyway, so which is the only continent not to have staged a Summer Olympic Games? Alright, that thought again, So that's the end of round 4. And what about this one? This is Muse, by the way. Beautiful song. for you. Aye, Muse, Map of Problematique. Yeah. Was used in the opening ceremony. Muse, one of the bands that you love or hate, really, in some respects, but I think their first couple of albums were all right, but then it really went off. They went downhill after that, I have to say. Right, okay, music intros is next, folks. You'll hear the start of a song, name the artist and the song. Okay, 20 points up for grabs here. All you have to do in this one is remember that the song titles include a metal colour, like a gold or bronze or silver. I don't know why I said them that way around, because that's not the right way, of course. So remember that when you're thinking about the answer. So the song titles we hear include the word gold, silver or bronze. Yeah. Okay. So you're all going, ah, Spandau Ballet. Spandau Ballet, gold's going to be in here. No, it's not. Blocked. It's blocked in Singapore for us. Aye, that's the weird things that can happen with us. Aye. Mm-hmm. Right. Anyway. Here we go. Here is, you know, well, Gary, it'd be good if you actually just get to the... Okay, so here's number one. All right. Usual thing. Artist and song. So that was number one there for you. Okay, name the song, which includes either gold, silver or bronze in its title, and the artist, of course. Right, here's number two. Number two for you. Sampled that track. Right, question number four. Again, name the artist and the song. Here it is. Song featuring a certain movie, and actually he was in it. Right, okay, now we move on to number five. Name this one. I about 30 seconds of these songs and that's your whack. Right, okay, so that was five. Now we are on to number six. Number six, folks, here we go.
Once there was a way to get back homeward. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry.
Okay, so that was number six. Let's move on to seven.
Seven.
Wee bop. See how you go with this one.
It felt cold inside, so we threw the radio onto the fire. It felt good to watch it burn away to nothing.
Okay, so that was number seven there. Let's move on to number eight. Now, number eight. This one.
I don't want to wait anymore. I'm tired of looking for answers. Take me someplace where there's music and there's laughter. I don't know if I'm scared of dying, but I'm scared of living too fast, too slow. Regret, remorse, hold on. No, no, I gotta go.
Probably remember that. I think it's in an advert for a motor or something. I don't know. Anyway, but who is it and what's the song? Right, your penultimate one, number nine here in this round. Tune of that always reminds me of the music for John Carpenter's The Thing. I don't think I've listened to that song. Anyway. Right, so that was nine. And here is your final one. Number 10. Right, you maybe got the theme tune there for that. Well, no, the theme tune, the title there in that one, but maybe more difficult to get the artist. Okay, you can rewind them back and listen to them again, that's up to you. But for the moment, we'll have a wee break and then the answers will be coming your way soon. Yes, very soon. Very soon. In the meantime, this guy appeared at that, and I'm not a massive fan, but I think this is a funny wee, great wee tune. Good wee party tune. Good wee party tune.
I wake up every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy bass line is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip. Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me.
Bonkers.
Every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip.
Bonkers.
Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. And I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Ooh, yeah, I'm man.
In the floor now.
No, back then, back then.
Floor. Back then.
I wake up every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip. Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me.
It's under 3 minutes long. It's a clacking. It's a cracking wee track. Armand Van Helden's the producer of it, of course. The man that did... what was that one he did? You Can't... Oh, God. You Don't Know Me. You don't even know me. You said it no matter body. I'm singing like Vic Reeves for the, remember the club singer for Shooting Stars? Anyway, sure. Right, let's get your answers, folks. National Anthems was your first one. And this is what it was. This was number one. Brazil. Number two there was France. This is number three. That's Australia. Australia. Number four there is Germany. Germany. Yep, that's number five there. That is Russia. Russia. Number six there for you is Spain. 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 España. There for you. Bit of a boring one, that, actually. For the country it is, it's Jamaica. Number seven, Jamaica. What'd you make of that? Ah, you know that one. That's, of course, America. America. Number nine there, of course, Italia. Italia. Number 10 there, he has, I see, expecting a bit of Gary Cooper or John Wayne to bob into the picture there. But it's actually the national anthem of China. China, yeah. Oh, please, Mr. Trump. Okie dokie. So let's get clarification on those answers there, folks. There we are. There is your national anthem's answers for round number one. Okay. Round two was picture round. We were looking for the Olympians. So, right, let's quickly fire through these. Because number one, that's Carl Lewis. Carl Lewis, of course, sprinter and long jumper. Two was a great Scottish swimmer, David Wilkie. Number three, that's the other swimmer. Well, it's not just David Wilkie and her that are swimmers. There's loads more, but anyway, that's Rebecca Adlington. Number four, the lassie eating chips in the clockwork, that's Sally Pearson, the 100-metre hurdler. Number five is another Scot, that's Catherine Granger, Kath Granger, the rower. Number six, on the water again, that's the sailor Ben Ainslie. Very rich, very rich. You need to be for the day in that sport, don't you? Number seven, Haile Gebrselassie, the great Ethiopian long-distance runner. Number eight, that's Kelly Holmes. Won 800 metres in 1500, wasn't it? Number nine is Michael Phelps, the great American swimmer. And number 10 is Nadia Comăneci, the Romanian gymnast, of course. There's clarification of those. Probably seen it earlier on, but anyway. There you are. Round three was name the host city, and the answers are these. Number one, 1936, it was Berlin. Berlin was the host city. Remember? No? Okay. Number two, 1992, Barcelona. Number three, the year 2000 was in Sydney. Number four, 1976 was Montreal. Number five, 1948 was London, the first games after the World War II. I think London was due stage in 1940. That's how they were. Got it then. 1980 was Moscow. Number seven, the first modern Olympics, of course, in 1896 were in Athens. 1960, the games were in Rome. 1968, Mexico City. Always have to put in Mexico, you know. And the final one there, number 10, 1956, Melbourne. Melbourne there was your answers. Right, now number four, there was just sort of general questions about the Olympics. Usain Bolt broke the world record for both the 100 and 200 metres at which Olympic Games, that was in Beijing in 2008. Question two, who did Andy Murray defeat in the gold medal match at the 2016 Rio Olympics? That was the Argentine Juan Martín del Potro in an epic final. Question three, at which Games was a bomb planted at the Olympic Park where fans gathered? The bomb detonated whilst an evacuation was taking place, killing one person. That was at the Atlanta Games in 1996. Question four, although he represented Canada, in which country was disgraced sprinter Ben Johnson born? That was in Jamaica. Question five, in 2016, golf returned to the Olympics. Which golfer won the gold medal in the men's individual event? That was Justin Rose, Englishman. Question six, which of the following cities has never hosted an Olympic Games, Summer Olympic Games? Antwerp, Helsinki, St. Louis or Madrid? It's Madrid. Madrid's never hosted it. Question seven, I've bidded for it many a times, I think. Question seven, since the Second World War, the leading nation at the Olympic Games has either been the Soviets or the USA, apart from twice, once when it was a unified team made up of ex-Soviets in 92, but which other nation has topped the medals table at the Games? That's China in 2008 when they hosted it. Question eight, which one of the following sports has featured at a Summer Olympics? Cricket, squash, bowls or horse racing? It's cricket. Back in 1900, Great Britain won the gold. Question nine, who was the director of the Olympic opening ceremony at the London 2012 Games? That was your man, Danny Boyle. Danny Boyle, of course. And question number 10, which is only continent not to have staged a Summer Olympics? That is Africa. The Africans have never staged that. Right, your next round was the music one. Folks, let's play you these. If I can find them.
Where have they gone? Oh my God.
There we are. Right, number one was this. That is, of course, Fool's Gold by the Stone Roses. That there, number two, was Jeff Beck with High Ho Silver Lining. Number three there, Simple Minds with New Gold Dream. Number four there, that was David Soul with Silver Lady. That, of course, is Shed 7 with Going for Gold. That was number 5. 6.
Once there was a way to get back home.
That was Elbow with Golden Slumbers. This was 7.
Felt cold inside, so we threw the...
Some of you might have got the band, I don't know, a Scottish band. Anyway, it's Idlewild with Bronze Medal. Bronze Medal is the name of the song. This was 8. Number 8 there was First Aid Kit with My Silver Lining. 9. That was your Australian there, man. Sam Sparrow with Black and Gold. Black and Gold. And your final one. That was Golden Scans by the Klaxons. The Klaxons there. There's clarification of your answers there, folks. Remember, a point for the artist and a point for the song title. Two silver linings in there, folks. Yeah. That's how good it is. Yeah. Anyway. That is it, folks. Thanks again. I said thanks for your support, but I think that's from a previous old quiz. Look out for more special quizzes. They will come up. Who knows? Subscribe to my channel, my YouTube channel, this channel here, for updates. So if you click on subscribe, you will get notification as to when a new quiz has been released. Yes, mm-hmm. You will. Quite well, good as well.
Now I like to say, goodbye to all my fellow friends. And if you like this shit on here, I'll see your ass again.
Well, indeed, folks, you take care of yourselves out there. Stay safe, Quizzles, and I'll be seeing you sometime in the future with another special quiz, I imagine. Keep safe, stay safe, keep well. Bye.